Oops.
I'm live? Great. Hello, welcome to the literally the best game in the world, Hollow Knight, on a Chinese version. I'm Xylo, and I'm showing you the Any% No Magic Glitches category. I'll show you when the timer starts. That's an accident. So we can read those Chinese lines if you can read Chinese. And time is running even when I'm falling down, so after this scene, when I cancel it. So just write... Ah? Sorry. Now the run begins. So. So we begin with a big fall, so the knight just randomly jumps down the great cliff. And we can cancel that. Normally the knight would be stunned by the height he fall, but we can cancel that by opening the menuing and then opening the inventory. I will often open the inventory during a drop because it just cancels this animation. So, you fall faster if you open the inventory. And yes, Hollow Knight is a Metroidvania developed by Team Cherry. You can buy it for $15 on Steam. It's a great game, you should give it a try. And this run is a great showcase of Hollow Knight because it doesn't spoil that much because I do some sequence breaks during the run. So I'm using a route you would probably never do it casually. And yeah, we are the knight. We are a silent protagonist. And we are on a journey through Hollow Nest. Ah, damn. You can one-shot this these guys with the rock over there. But I don't know the timing yet. I'm playing on the one on the version 1.2.2.1, and there is the timing is a bit different from the newest version. On the newest version, I can kill those guys, but doesn't matter, I guess. The reason I'm running on this version is one of the reasons is the inventory drops works on this version, and some skips later on just works on this version. So I'm on my way to the first boss, but we won't fight it till the end. Because we don't need his loot, and it's just faster to skip it. So this is the False Knight. I think he's called like that. Five, six, seven, eight. So now we can go like this. Yeah, and then we go to the first, I think he's called Snail Shaman. I would translate it from the German to this. And he will give us the first ability, first very important ability. if my gamepad wanted to work. I'm so deep into the speedrunning, I even forgot the real English name for this. We called it just a fireball, but I'm pretty sure that's not the real name. Vengeful Spirit, I think it was. But fireball is just easier. Ah, can break those two in one shot. So the first it's a tiny mini boss, I would call him. He needs four shots, and you can shoot three fireballs with full soul, and you have to wait till he spit one of his child to get more soul to spit a fourth time. And you, as you can see, Chinese is the fastest language because you can mash the text boxes really fast. So, coming up is a next cool trick, only works before Lifeblood. Lifeblood is a content update. Which literally balanced some stuff and removed super pretty much speedrunning stuff like this. The fireball just stick into the enemy. Damn. And you just can kill him with one fireball instead of four. That's pretty cool. And we are on our way to the second boss called Hornet, where we can where we get our second very important ability. And for that we need some soul, because we need the fireball to get some skips. The first one is what wasn't really important. The second one is pretty important. This could save some second. No. Ah, don't. Well, it's a backup strat. You can get this tiny guy and just do. Oh my god! No! Ah, I hate you. Where are you? Come up. I suck so much. Oh, I'm sorry. Do-do-do. I don't want to go all the way around. Come on, Xylo. What are you doing? So. Thanks. So, all good things are three, or how the saying goes. That's how it should look like. So, I need some geo, because it's pretty important to, that I buy some stuff. I think that's not good either. So you, in this game there are some arenas where you have to kill all the guys which are coming up. I think we just passed all of them, but that's a mechanic in the game. Some areas are closed by a fence, and you have to kill all the enemies in it. I'm taking some time to heal, because the boss can be really trolly. I shouldn't die, but safety first. If you are into speedrunning and think about running this game as your first speedrun game, remember, this is a really, really unforgiving speedrun. It's pretty hard. I have a lot of fun with it, but it can be pretty cruel. Normally, Hornet will talk to you, but if you shoot him before he can start his talk, her talk. Oh, that was a pretty good fight. Then she just starts attacking you without talking to you. So then this is the really important part where you use the mouse to not delete the first profile. So, we acquired the dash, which will be used pretty much often. Super often in this run now, from now on. By the way, I'm pretty sorry for my English. It's not the greatest of the world. So, that's not the ideal way to go down there, but it works for me, so I use it. And it's fast enough. Shoutouts to the noises in this game, they are pretty great. And this game is super atmospheric, so if you love some stuff like this, so upcoming trick is my favorite trick, but unfortunate is one of the unsatisfying if it not work. Great, first try. Yeah, basically, for some reason you can pogo off this explosion and get up there. Normally you would need the Mantis Claws, which I'm about to get now. So, and using these guys to get over here saves about 20 seconds or something. It can be trolley as well. So, this is a third ability, which is pretty important. So basically, the run is about getting all the stuff you need and beating the last boss. So everything I pick up is super important, you can imagine. Now we can wall jump, and wall jumping, every game which has wall jump is has great plus points. Can do pretty neat stuff with it. And the mechanics of the dash is if you dash one time in air, you can't dash another time. But if you hug the wall for 1 second, you can dash another time. Oops. Or if you pogo from something, you it's refresh it as well. So, now I buy this stack station over here, because when I beat one dreamer, or if I kill one dreamer, this little gap right here is closed. And if I don't buy the stack station, I'm pretty much screwed, because I think I have to beat the boss, which is super off the route. So this mini boss is pretty annoying, because it has not much life, but it has a huge death animation, and after this, it explodes into some cute flies, which you have also to kill. Oh my god, one. So, the lovely love, what am I doing? Lovely love of Salupra. Say hello to Salupra, he is selling us the greatest the greatest talisman in this game. Charm. Charm is the name. And now we are dying, because there's another mechanic in the game we can abuse. If you die, you leave a shadow behind. And we can use this shadow to skip a thing. So we respawn on a bench you sit on. The bench are checkpoints, basically. And you can change charms on the bench. So, no, don't do that. So, this is calling the shade skip. So basically, if you're on a marathon and tell everyone, I will donate $5 for every death, you basically have to pay $5 in this run, because you have to die. And now, we are collecting the probably the least important ability in this game, because it's not necessary for the run, but it's necessary to beat the game. So, as we don't use it that much. It's called the Dream Nail, and story-wise, for some reason the dreamers are trying to imprison us, and for another reason I don't know, we are getting freed by a moth, I think, and this moth giving us a dream nail. I'm falling off here, because for the real time it doesn't matter, but the in-game time stops a little, and we are we're speedrunners. Care about the in-game time, so we can do it even in marathon, even it doesn't care, it doesn't matter. There was no event run which I'm not falling off. So this is the Dream Nail. It has two abilities. We can go into the dreamer's dreams and kill them, and we can get gain souls on living enemies. So now I'm pressing, mashing the start button, so to cancel this. This is pretty funny, because normally there would be a short sequence where the knight stands up, but while doing the open the menu and leave it again, for some reason I can move freely. So, now the real game begins. We are on our way to the City of Tears, a city where it always rains, because you saw the lake I cheesed up. This town is right... the lake is just above it, And yeah, the water from you see from here is basically just the water from the lake. Come on. So no risk, no fun. There's an item up here. I need. So now I can damage boost down here. It's a bit faster. And I can just rest here. So, here is an enemy which is called the George's Husk. Oh my god. Thank you. And funny Easter egg, it drops 420 geo. There are some more things. Man. Want to heal. Bump! Didn't expect you there. So, coming up is the reason why we play this version, because I can activate this lever just in this version from below. And this is the most important reason why we use this version. One little downside. Come on. I don't hear properly. Aha. It's just because I think the sound has a tiny bit of delay. Could it be? That's... Normally I don't have any problems with it. Those guys. Always trolling. They never jump, but when you... When you're expecting them not to jump, they jump. Yeah, let's try. I forgot something. Oh no, I don't. Muscle memory for the win. I even thought it wouldn't be that that big of a deal. So now we are selling those relics we got. And mouse threads. I really don't forget it. Didn't forget. Coming up is probably the hardest part of the run. I have zero upgrades. And I have to kill the Watcher Knights. So have fun with the upcoming fights. Please don't be disappointed if I die. First one. There are five more. I'm a bit scared, to be honest. Perfect. There are two more. Perfect. Better safe than sorry. Oh, perfect. First try. So that's basically the hardest part of the run is done and I'm great. Yeah, the audience is clapping for me, I guess. Why do I have so much geo? Oh, but it's good, I guess. So now you see the story part that matters in this game. These are the dreamers, and I have to kill them. Because they steal away a vessel which is about to break. And we have to fix that. But the seals are so good that we have to kill the religion to remove them. Hard life for them. So the one with one eye is called the Watcher. I have no idea why one eye is enough to watch. So sometimes the game can softlock here, but thank God it didn't. So now we are on our way to a shopping tour. Ah, that's why. Yeah, I remember. So, this is the stack. Buck. And this is why we can use this to get the Crystal Dash, which is the last upgrade, I think. Yeah, it should be. But for that, we need this lantern, because we are about to enter a dark room. And when something is in a dark room, the knight can't read what is written on a sign. And that's a cool reason to buy a lantern, I think. In the very early version of Hollow Knight, we didn't even need the... the lantern for that, so we don't have to spend 1.8k geo, and we would do this blind, kinda. And that's pretty brutal in my opinion. Need this life. So this is RNG, in which side the bug is moving. Thank God it's moving the same direction we get in. So let's... No, this is not the room. Oh, no, nice combo. So just reel here once more. So we should be fine. There's one damage boost I have to take again to do a fast strat. Oops. So now we have to take this damage. Oh, that's not good. Okay, let's don't do the fast cycle. But good enough. And that's how we get the Crystal Dash. And more strats. Normally in my home I use the first file. But I don't want to delete it, so I have to use the second file. So, and the Crystal Dash can do this. It lasts as long as you cancel it, or as long as you hit the wall. And with this we can do some sequence breaks. Things the developer didn't want to do it that way. For example, can we go in this direction? And do the first asset skip. Well, the only asset skip, the other one is a pretty hard one. This one is pretty easy. And we aren't supposed to be here right now, but we are here. And we are on our way to the third boss? No, the fourth boss. And I do a safety save. Because you will never know. So I sit on this bench. And normally, we are supposed to have Isma's tier here. And Isma's tier allows us to swim in this acid, but we don't, so we have to not use Crystal Dash. And say hello to Umu. Umu is a big jellyfish. We can't damage it yet. We have to wait for a friend to help us. And this friend is called Quirrell, and it has to strike it once, so it gets vulnerable. Okay. Good enough, I guess. So my goal is a 3-cycle. Just shut up, Quirrell. No one likes you. No! Okay, this will be pretty... No! I hate you. Why are you doing this? So the goal in this fight is to bait Umu in this middle platform. So he just do 2 attacks. And then, oh man. And then he gets vulnerable. Yeah, thanks. So, now we have to pay attention. All right. So, now the sad story about Quirrell. Quirrell is lost in Hollow Nest as well. You can find him on many places when you play through Hollow Knight. And he just don't know his purpose, and we can follow him to do his purpose, as he remembered. He carries the mask of the teacher with him, and when the time comes, he has to revive his master so we can kill her. That's the story of Quirrell. So, one boss is coming. One boss is missing, but so the next region we visit has no boss. It has only the Dreamer. But believe me, that's enough. The region itself feels like a boss sometimes. So how is it called? Arachnophobia? Afraid of spiders? I guess you have to look away for the next few minutes, because we are about to enter a very scary place. So, say hello to Deep Nest. Deep Nest is one of the scariest places I ever met in a game. It has no real music, it has just this crawly noises of some horrible creatures. It has dark places. It has spiders in the foreground. It's just a disgusting place. Good job, Team Cherry. Oh, didn't see him. And imagine playing through this without the lantern. You would see nothing. And there were times when we did this without the lantern. I don't know why, but it was a terrible time. Oops. So, going right here. And there are some nice creatures which offer us a bench. But, oh no, I can't move, no! Oh, help us, help me! Some random noises. And now we are caught. And this is a super great labyrinth. Wait. So after this, we need come on. We need 250 geo. And we are super off. That's not good. Can you not? Thanks. And free the grubby, because I can. So. Why are you moving backwards? That's just a tiny bit. I want to breathe. Come on. Thanks. So, 60... Oops. The last dreamer without a boss. I need Geo, though. Let's hope that's enough. I don't want to beat another one. But maybe I have to. So there's one here. That should be enough. Yeah, all right. We're good to go. So now we are on the way of to the last boss of the game. And when it dies, it still isn't time, and that wasn't good. I just wanted to hold the soul, but well. So, since we have full life, we can ignore the bench before the Hollow Knight. Even if we die, we would spawn on this bench right in front of it. So, and yeah, you are not playing as the Hollow Knight. Many players would think of it. This little guy we free right now, this is the Hollow Knight. If you can read Chinese, you will read it all right there. There, Hollow Knight. Oh, done. Damn, right? Oops. All right. Third phase, he's stabbing himself because you can't get stabbed by the hero if you stab yourself or something like that. Oops. No, I want to stay on the left. Why? I have to heal! Stupid boss. Be dead! Okay, last phase. As I said, time is not when the boss dies, time is when the ending cutscene is starting. I will call it. Alright, he's dead. Now I have to absorb him. Shout out to the music, by the way. And time. pretty solid run, I can think. Thanks for watching, everyone, and I hope... What? I hope you you enjoyed it, and you will give this game a shot. Every time I show this on the event, I say it's the best game in the world, and I really think about it that way. And yeah, I'm good to go. Thanks for having me on this event, and enjoy the rest.
All right, now that was a really good run. We're going to continue the spookiness with Yume Nikki 3D Any% with Allegra. It's coming up real soon. Keep on touch.